Hey, basketball coaches and basketball players, today I'm going to give you some fantastic three-post basketball plays that you can run against any zone, and believe me, it'll actually feel almost like if you're cheating. I'm serious. This is such an easy play to run against traditional zone defenses. These are zone defenses like the 2-3 and the 3-2 zone defense. Let's get down to the clipboard. Let's check these out. So first, let's say we're running up against a 2-3 zone defense. Well, a three-post zone, or a three-post offense, I should say, is when you've got two perimeter players and you've got a triangle of players in the key. And I would suggest them all being centers or forwards, kind of like your biggest, strongest players on the court. Now, why is this important? So number one, what I want to do is have player one dribble over towards this left side. That's going to be then lifting up and moving over a lot of the players. Now, what I want to see happen is player one passing the ball to player three. Now, if you're over on this side, I want to see player three over on that elbow. So what's going to happen now is player five will most likely be raised up, and if player three can pass down to player four quick enough, that should be a layup. If it's not quick enough, we need player 4 to seal on this side, which means his back is to player 3, so that player 3 blue can pass that ball into player 4 to get that layup. Now, why is this important? The reason why we want to seal is because now he's going to have an open layup. Now, if player 4 does come over, which he should not be coming over to defend this, we can have a simple pass over to player 5. This is just an easy play that you can run. Now, when you're up top and you can then dribble towards the middle, that's going to be collapsing those two players. What you can have now happen is, well, player four is going to be kind of moving up. We're going to have player five and three moving up. We can have a pass into player three. What's going to happen? Player three could take that shot. If he raises up to player three, we can have a pass down to player five, especially if player five is sealing on this side. We can have an easy layup. Or what can also happen is player 4 may then move down to guard player 5. We'll have player 3 guarding player 4. We can then pass out to player 2, because I can tell you right now, player 1 will probably bounce down to player 3. Another option that can be coming out of this is if player 3 had that ball and everyone is covered in single coverage, after that initial pass into player 3, we can have player one cut out towards this side, which then creates almost like a triangle offense. And then we can have player three pass out to player one for that three-point shot. Or what we can have happen is if player four does pop out and we get a pass into player five quick enough, that could be a layup as well. So the faster you pass the ball in these plays, the faster you're going to be able to open up weaknesses in that team's zone defense, and you're going to be able to exploit that and get easy layups. Now let's check out a couple of plays that you can run against a 3-2 zone. Now against a 3-2 zone, we have to know the bubbles that we have up top, and these are double team locations. So what I want to have is player one attack the gap between player one and two. That's going to collapse those two players. We're going to have a pass into player three, and he can take that shot. Notice how these are all very similar to the 2-3 zone offense plays. Now, if that does bring in player three red, we now have a three-point shot by player two. If that doesn't bring in that player and we have player 4 pop up and player 5 then guards both of those players, if he was a good defender, we could have literally a pass to either one of those two players and they can go in for a baby hook or just a quick shot off the backboard. If no player comes up, obviously he could take that shot. After you make that pass in, however, I really would like to see player 1 cutting around the 3-point line, and the reason for this is if one of these players was to collapse on player 3, player 3 could pass out to player 2, and then player 2 could pass over to player 1. So this is going to be then making the zone defense stretch, and we can have an easy extra pass into the low post for player 5 to get an easy, easy layup. However, as you can see with most of these plays against a zone defense, we're literally just reading the defense, seeing what the defensive players are doing, and watching what post player is open. What we want to do with these plays against a zone defense, we're not necessarily running set plays over and over and over again. What we're doing is just reading the defense. What we're trying to do is, with every single or every other pass, is to try and get that ball into the high post. That is our goal. Our goal is to get that ball into the high post, number one. Our secondary option is the low post. I want every other pass to go into the post, and we're really trying to focus on the high post because that brings up those baseline defenders, and that's going to allow us to do a high post to low post pass, and then we're going to be able to get easy layups. Now, I understand that most teams are now trying to focus on three-point shots, but if you can start destroying a team's defense in the low post or in the high post, and they're running a zone defense, that's going to be switching them out of a zone defense, and it's going to open up multiple different opportunities for you to open up three-point shots, because as we've seen here, this offense still does open up three-point shots for us. However, what we would do here is lots of teams, especially at the younger age group, what we're talking about is like the 10, 11, 12, 13-year-olds here in North America, a lot of their coaches are only teaching them zone defense and they're not teaching them man-to-man. And because of that, if we can exploit these zone defenses so easily like these plays, what you're going to do is now make that team who may never have practiced a man-to-man defense, who may never have ran a shell drill, to now be forced into running a man-to-man defense. And now you're going to be able to have a heyday with them, because if they've never really ran a man-to-man defense and they may be switching every screen or whatever it may be, you could literally run any set play and you're going to destroy them. So if you're a coach who's only running zone defense, please also teach them a man. It's not just for their future development. It's also for you to win more games. Because if your team is forced to run a man-to-man and you've never taught them a man-to-man, you're stuck. So these simple read and react basketball plays are going to help your team win more games. If you've enjoyed today's video, hit that like button and subscribe. And I will see you guys again next time.